You have learned that plants, animals, and microorganisms are able to form and maintain an ecosystem. It is therefore important to know which species are present in the area and what role they play within the ecosystem. The number of species within an ecosystem is called biodiversity. Biodiversity is one of the fundamentals of ecology and of life. Species diversity is an essential element of ecosystem functioning. It generally enhances productivity of ecosystems and increases stability of ecosystems. This can be illustrated by a simple example. Imagine we have a grassland with two species, a blue and a green species. The blue species is more productive when it is colder, and the green species is more productive when it is warmer. When the grassland only contains the blue species, the grassland will lose productivity under suboptimal warm temperatures. However, in mixed grasslands, the other species can take over. In this way, a grassland with two species with different traits has a more stable productivity. The system is also more resilient to temperature changes. Additionally, overall annual productivity of the mixed species grassland may be higher, as the growing season of both species may not completely overlap. This allows them to partially replace each other within a year. In this way, the productivity and stability of this grassland increases. In addition, biodiversity is also considered to increase the resilience of ecosystems. The term resilience refers to the capacity of an ecosystem to accommodate disturbances. It is easy to understand why biodiversity increases ecological resilience. A forest with only one single type of tree species is very vulnerable to diseases or to storms that can wipe out the whole forest. In a multiple species forest, a disturbance will not affect all species in a similar way, increasing the survival chances of the forest. A resilient ecosystem is able to bounce back to the original ecosystem state after a foreseeable disturbance. This ecological resilience can be envisaged as a ball in a bowl. With each disturbance, the ball is pushed out of equilibrium, but will roll back to its original position. However, if this ball is pushed too hard, it will be pushed out of the bowl. In analogy, if the disturbance is too strong, the ecosystem cannot recover and will shift towards another state. This is also called a phase shift. In the previous video, we have already discussed such a phase shift. When small herbivores were removed from a coral reef, the ecosystem shifted from a coral-dominated system to an algae-dominated system. We have talked about productivity, stability, and resilience of ecosystems in the light of biodiversity. However, ecosystems are never entirely constant. They adapt to perturbations and changes in conditions. Ecosystems are not engineering structures that are solid and stay in place. Dynamics form an intrinsic part of ecosystems, and large disturbances of these dynamics could lead to a phase shift towards formation of a different ecosystem.